Hello, welcome back to my channel, and today we are playing Draugen. We're continuing
Wake
with
up,
episode
Edward.
8. Oh, still the stone team.
Stop hiding. Without us, you are nothing. You cannot hide from us.
Where's Lissy?
Alice is not here.
Bring her back. Please. I need her.
Alice does not love Elizabeth like you do.
She loves me.
Not like I do, Edward.
Who are you?
I'm tired. Please. I think of you so often. You have no idea.
You just want me to forgive you so that we can keep looking for your precious, perfect Betty.
She needs us.
She never needed you, Teddy Bear. And she certainly doesn't need us.
I can't find her on my own.
It's just too bad, my darling Edward. Because we're done playing second fiddle to little sis.
Wait, don't go. I'm talking to... To you. Lissy.
My head hurts. Oh, it's raining.
Listen. Lissy. Please. You can't keep vanishing on me.
Try.
Why are you so angry?
You do not know anger.
God damn it.
Do you ever meet my father?
Alice does not want to speak with you.
What about you? Are you going to help me?
God helps those who help themselves.
I don't want to see you.
I don't need God's help.
You're weird.
I need Lissy.
Do you, though? Did you ever?
Of course, I...
Where are you? So I cannot go out, okay. I wish you success. Room full. Oh yeah, I forgot to put Betty's glove. Oh, so I cannot put the glove. Okay then. Maybe she's in the kitchen. Ah, see? I know where she is.
Alice. Don't go. Hear me out. I depend on you both.
You can never depend on other people, Edward.
I'm not sure you count as other people.
Everyone leads one way or another.
You don't. You can't.
Is that a challenge?
Stop playing games.
Are you ordering me, Teddy Bear?
I'm asking you.
Didn't your father always tell you to stand up for yourself? To be a real man and not a sissy? Maybe that's why he put the gun to his head and pulled the trigger. Kaboom! He was so disappointed about what his only son had turned into.
A monster.
Faith wants to know one. Old fruit.
Here. Lissy, I'm tired of chasing you. Alice, be reasonable. I'm trying to talk to you. Lissy, look. Her jacket. I'm sure it wasn't here yesterday.
Jesus Christ,
Betty was
Teddy.
Here. Perhaps when we were out yesterday.
Betty,
Betty.
Do you love Betty more than you love us? But don't you see? What has Betty done that we haven't?
I don't even know what the fuck are you?
Cannot? We've always been there for you. Why do you keep looking for her?
She's real. You're not.
So?
What? You decide what is real. We are real to you.
We'll never be the same.
She does not want you.
Who are you talking
about? Why do you think Betty left? She was sick and tired of us. She wanted to escape.
Like mother.
Diggle.
Drowning herself because she couldn't stand being around us.
Like father.
Bang! Right in the coconut.
Stop.
You drive them all away, Edward. All into death.
Not us. We're always here for you.
I beg you.
You are never alone.
Stop!
Back away from me!
Leave me alone, both of you!
You want to be alone?
You really want to be alone?
Yeah.
Fine.
Lissy.
I still like Copper Lissy. I'm not gonna Copper Lissy. I think we need food though, because well, as a person, it's like, oh, okay, that one was short. Now I thought we're gonna continue with this again. That one was too short.
Eddie? Elizabeth? Is that you?
Who you? Okay, that's just the... Ah, god damn. That is just the mannequin. Ah, my head hurts.
Are you upstairs? Betty, I'm coming.
Oh, that looks cheerful. I think it's just a rat.
Betty?
Or goat.
Betty! Are you in there? Open the door! I'm coming in! Stand away from the door! Who? Ready? No! No, 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 no! Oh. I thought it was you, Betty. But who? Anna.
Wait, she wasn't here before this?
You said this was a gift from another unlucky suitor. Precious to you. You wouldn't have left it here unless a signpost, a breadcrumb. What's so important about the Fretlands? I will figure this out. I will find you, I promise. It's from Johan, addressed to his wife. Did you notice the handwriting, Betty? He was clearly distraught. Knock, ere knock. Enough is enough. After decades of strife, I pray that God will forgive me. I am tired of secrets. For 20 years, I have kept my silence about our discovery. My silence has only led to misfortune, and my cowardice has only led to death. I will make Frederick pay for what he has done to us, for what they have done to our roof. When it is over, I will let the ocean take me to you and Ruth. May God forgive me. And I was already dead when he wrote this. He had no one else to confess to. What now, Betty? Johann went to confront his brother, probably at Frederick's farm. And then? You follow Johann to Frederick Fretland's farm, and then to the mine. You wouldn't let this go, Betty. You'd follow your story to the end. All the way to the end.
Don't you think that this body should be buried or something? Like, should you still gonna leave this body up here? Yeah, you stay there.
Did you go to the mine, Betty? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Is Frederick's farm. A railroad track. You must have seen them, Betty. They lead to the mine.
This is a weird mystery game, but I like it. Although the interaction is hard because you do not... It forces you to do what you want. It's limitation. Too foggy, you can see shit.
What led you to this place? All these fragments. You'd piece them together into a story, wouldn't you, Betty? So, what do we know? Johann and Frederick are partners, and on good terms. Something happened in the mine. Disagreements lead to a falling out. And at the end of it all, 20 years later, Johann walks this path to confront Frederick. Was this your doing, Johann? Did you burn your brother's farm to the ground? And where were you, Betty? Did you witness their fall?
Frame rates. But it's because I'm recording as well, that's why the frame rates drop. Some games, the frame rates drop when recording. I will see a burning house. Now it's okay. I dropped the resolution scale.
Betty? Are you here, Betty?
Simon Fetling.
Simon's grave. Born December 5th, 1909. Died September 17th, 1923. Safe. Frederick would choose numbers that meant something to him. Why bury Simon here and not at the cemetery? The village blamed him for Ruth's death. I can really use your imagination, Betty. You'll figure this out in no time. Let's try Simon's birthday. Another Viking artifact, Betty. Most likely from the same treasure Ruth found. Postmarked in Boston. That's it. Curious coincidence. Dear Frederick, I hope this letter... It's in English, Betty. Hope this letter finds you and the boy in good health. We're concerned about you both. No word from you for almost 2 years now. All of us still heartbroken about Margaret's passing. We know things have been difficult for you and Simon.
He keeps monologuing as if Betty's there. That is weird. Don't
Mr. Fretmore, we expect you to take care of this problem. If the discovery is made public, the authorities will intervene and the mine will be shut down. Should this happen, we will consider it a breach of our contract and we will withdraw our investment. You and your brother will be responsible for all debts and losses. Johann must be convinced to wall up the chamber. We have already dealt with the worker who made the discovery. The Fretland Mining Company. I wonder what this unlocks.
The mine, maybe.
You went to the mine. I hope our guardian angel watched over you.
Where's the mine? There, so I just need to find the mine.
All right, Betty. So what happens next in your story? Johann and Frederick discover something in the mine. A cave or chamber of archaeological value. They argue about what to do. The discovery is made public. It's the end of their enterprise. Johann is convinced, or paid, to walk away. Their secret stays hidden. Then, a few months later,
what's that?
The accident. Three men die. The investors pull out, the mine shuts down, Frederick's up to his neck in debt.
No, like we had. It's not to be discovered that part, what the?
So, 20 years pass. and feud tears the village apart, setting neighbor against neighbor. And then, Ruth stumbles across the secret in the mine. After all this time, the truth may finally come to light. She died. And the day after, Simon is murdered. It's a catalyst. Old grievances resurface. No matter who you stand with, you're a traitor. Things escalate. More people die. From disease, despair, suicide, murder. Of the mine, because of what they found there and what they covered up. There was no one to stop it, Betty. You were alone. That's the real curse of Grovik. Isolation.
Well, that's another good curse. That is true, though.
This place is cursed. Ridiculous.
What the heck?
Ruth was here the day she fell. Something spooked her, and then she ran all the way to the cliff where... Do you know what happened, Betty? Did you witness it?
This shit.
Hello? Betty, are you in there? Please answer me.
Pennywise, the dancing clown.
This is Mother's brooch. You always wore this. You wouldn't take it off unless... You left it here for a reason. What am I not seeing?
So it's better getting naked second by second, like she discovers something and then... Oh! Took my clothes off. Is that it? Jump scare, god damn. Run. This is how you run? Wow. Hey, the curse is closed. No more curse.
Edward?
What?
Edward?
Betty?
The fuck?
Elizabeth? Is that you?
Edward?
I'm here,
Where
Betty!
Are you?
It's Edward! I'm on my way, Betty. Wait for me.
Come on, come on.
Edward!
Stay where you are! I can hear you! Hold on! I'm almost there!
Edward! Where are you?
I'm on my way!
Wait, Betty, wait! The frame rate!
Stay put, Betty! I'm coming for you!
Edward, please! Hurry!
I'm coming, Betty!
Why are you, like... further and further away from me. Like, this is far enough, and your voice will
I'm
not be...
There.
The fuck? See, your voice, if you stay in one place, your voice cannot be heard from there to the mines.
Penny? Penny? Just stay. Elizabeth? I'm on my way! Don't move, I'm coming for you! I'm here, Penny! It's Edward! It's me!
So this is not.
I'm coming.
Edward, is that
you're
you?
Here.
I'm in here.
You're inside the house.
No, you're not. It's the mannequin.
Elizabeth, there you are. Finally. You have no idea how long I've been looking for you. You had me so worried. Look, your brooch, Mother's brooch. You must have lost it at the mine.
Let me put it on for you, Betty. I wouldn't want you to lose it again.
She's been dead for 30 years. Elizabeth was never here. But we didn't come for her. We came for Johan, and Anna, and Frederick, and Simon, and Ruth. We're here to tell their stories.
No. Elizabeth. She's here.
You know Betty died when she was a baby. She drowned in the pond. And you found her. You were just 11. You carried her to your mother. Then your mother...
She hated you for that.
She could never forgive you for bringing her baby to her. And you could never forgive yourself for what she did after. You always forget this, because you don't want to be alone. So you bring Betty back, again, and again, to New York, to Boston, to the house. But always just out of reach, never quite there. The scent of her, the echo of her, but never really her. And all it does is make you lonelier.
But in the picture?
But the thing is, Edward, you're never alone.
You have us.
And you'll always have us.
I think this is...
Betty's...
His mother, I think.
She was never there for you. She couldn't be. You can't lose us. We're a part of you.
Forever. And ever. And ever.
But you need to let Betty go. There's not room for all of us in there.
I couldn't save you, Elizabeth.
I think it's his...
I'm so sorry.
Mother... That she... Is that right? Ah, great again. It's,
It is as painful to wake from a vision... ...as it is to be born in hell.
It's a fucking celebrity. Well, that's it for today's video. We had a revelation. Well, I see you dudes, all of you dudes, in the next video. I think this is the last one, right? Okay, yeah. Okay. Bye bye.